Let r of x equal the quotient of x minus 5 and x minus 7, solve r of x less than or equal to 0. This indicates we want to solve the rational inequality of the quantity x minus 5 divided by the quantity x minus 7 less than or equal to 0. To solve the rational inequality, we first want to verify it's in the correct form. The correct form is when we have a single quotient on the left and 0 on the right, which is our case. Step 2, we determine the zeros of the numerator and denominator. To determine the zero of the numerator, we set x minus 5 equal to 0 and solve for x, which gives us x equals 5. To find the zero of the denominator, we set x minus 7 equal to 0 and solve for x, which gives us x equals 7. Next, we plot the zeros on the number line. The zeros of the numerator are either open or closed points based upon the inequality symbol. If the inequality symbol is less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, the zeros of the numerator are closed points. If the inequality symbol is less than or greater than, we plot the zeros of the numerator as open points. In our case, because the inequality is less than or equal to, we plot x equals 5 as a closed point. This indicates x equals 5 does satisfy the inequality and is part of the solution. Notice when x equals 5, the fraction is equal to 0, and 0 less than or equal to 0 is true. The zeros of the denominator are always open points because that's where we have division by 0, and division by 0 is always undefined. So we plot 5 as a closed point, and 7 as an open point. The last step is to test the intervals we just created by selecting test values in each subinterval and then subbing them into the visual inequality. If the test value is true, the entire interval is true and is part of the solution. If the test value is false, the entire interval is false and the interval is not part of the solution. Let's go ahead and select our test values. To the left of 5, let's use 0. Between 5 and 7, let's use 6. To the right of 7, let's use 8. Let's first test x equals 0. Notice when x is equal to 0, the left side is negative 5 divided by negative 7, which simplifies to 5 sevenths. We have 5 sevenths less than or equal to 0, which is not true. 5 sevenths is not less than or equal to 0. Because the test value is false, the entire interval on the left is also false. And now we test x equals 6. When x is 6, we have 1 divided by negative 1, which simplifies to negative 1. Negative 1 less than or equal to 0 is true because the test value is true, the entire interval is true. And then finally, we test x equals 8. When x is 8, we have 3 divided by 1 or 3. 3 less than or equal to 0 is not true because the test value is false, the entire interval is false. This indicates the graph of the solution is the interval from 5 to 7, including 5 and not including 7. Let's now express this using interval notation. The solution using interval notation is the interval from 5 to 7. The interval is closed on 5 or it includes 5, and therefore we use a square bracket to the left of 5. The interval is open on 7 or doesn't include 7. We use a random parenthesis to the right of 7. This is the solution expressed using interval notation. Of course, we could also express the solution using inequalities. We could also say the solution is x greater than or equal to 5 and less than 7. I hope you found this helpful.